There are several thousand collisions involving trains each year, which result in over 1,000 injuries and several hundred deaths. A majority of these deaths occur when someone is struck by a train while trespassing on railroad property. Remember, railroad property is private property. Trespassing along railroad property is not only against the law, it's very dangerous. Avoid taking shortcuts. The only safe place to cross railroad tracks is at a designated crossing. Don't get caught dead on the tracks. Stay off, stay away, stay alive.
Visit Elmhurst.org to explore the new City of Elmhurst website. Find out the latest Elmhurst news, pay utility bills and parking tickets, report concerns, and much more. Elmhurst.org is an ideal way to discover what Elmhurst offers your business, your family, your life.
Good evening, I'm Diana Smith, the principal here at York High School, and on behalf of all of our students and of the faculty at York High School, I welcome you tonight to the York Collage Concert. This is a proud evening for our students, for their teachers, and for their parents and family. It's a night that we showcase our students in every level of the performing arts at York. Those who have just started in high school, all the way up to those who are performing in their last collage concert. We all know of the importance of the arts in education. We know of the intellectual benefits of studying music and the arts, that it improves our listening and language skills. But I think more important than that is what it brings to our lives. You know, there are some things in life that we will not agree on. Religion, politics, clothing styles. But the love of music and the arts is something that draws us together. It draws us together when we listen, when we play, when we sing, and when we dance. It crosses all boundaries, all nationalities, all races, all cultures, and all ages. Think of the last time that music moved you. In the car, listening to your headphones in the hallways, at the symphony, studying at home, in church, the national anthem at a sporting event, listening to the soundtrack of a movie, moving to the music at the homecoming dance. Oh, it moved you. And tonight, I would suggest you will be moved. I want to thank all of you for your support. We are blessed to be surrounded by a community and a district who consistently supports the arts because it is truly one of the most important aspects of a student's education, something we hope will follow you all of your lives. It is now my pleasure to introduce, to begin the performance tonight, the Symphony Strings, under the leadership of Mr. Ray Oswald, and our Advanced Dance Ensemble, under the leadership of Ms. Anna Sapoznikov.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, and welcome again to this year's Collage Concert. My name is Dawn Dickinson, and this is my final year serving as president of the York Music Parents Association, or YMPA. I'd like to take a few moments tonight to explain to you what YMPA does, some of the things we do anyway. We're a parent-run organization which supports the York Music Department and your students in a variety of ways. I would encourage you to check out our webpage, which you can find on the Parent Resources tab at the York website. And if you have any questions, you can email me directly from there. One way we support your music students is that each spring we offer stipends for those who apply and attend qualifying summer music camps, as well as presenting scholarships to selected students who are graduating from our program at the end of the year. Another way we support your students is that we are the facilitators for the annual green sale, which this year will run from October 4th to the 20th. Proceeds from the green sale benefit both the Music Parents Association and your students' accounts for future trips that they might take with their organizations. Whether your student is a freshman or a senior, I would encourage you to take the opportunity to take advantage of the green sale to earn money toward their trips. Forms for the green sale will be distributed to their students, but in case you don't receive them, they will also be available on our webpage. You can also support the York Music Department through the purchase of a patron pass, which many of you have already done, and we thank you for that. All of that money goes directly to the Music Department, and you can continue to purchase those either online or at your students' concerts throughout the year. And if you did not pick yours up tonight, you can pick it up at the first concert your child has this year. If you are a parent of a York Music student, you are part of the York Parents Association. We appreciate all of you who have volunteered your time tonight and at other times throughout the year, as well as our directors and their dedication to the music program. Please consider serving as a volunteer on one of our committees or as a member of our board. Several of our board members, including myself, will see our youngest students graduate from York this year, and we can always use new members. Tonight, I would also like to mention another part of York that I've been involved with this summer, which is called YSET, York Student Enrichment Team. This group has been actively fundraising to help students whose families have been affected by the increases in fees and other things this year at York. Those of us who are here tonight have all been affected by those fees as we now pay music department fees for our students to take part in the great programs we have. We want you to know that assistance is available to those families who complete an application and who meet the guidelines to qualify for assistance. You can also help these students by donating to YSET, which is also available as a parent resource on the York webpage. I'd like to invite you to attend the reception which follows the concert tonight in the cafeteria, and I want to say thanks to all the volunteers who helped make that reception possible and for all of you for bringing treats. We also hope we'll be hosting receptions after the spring concerts to honor our graduating seniors. And I'd also like to remind band and orchestra students that uniform pickup is tomorrow from 2:00 till 7:00. And if you'll join me now in congratulating the directors on this great concert, and we'd like to thank you for your continuing support of York's Music Department.
Thank you. Or we can cry, oh, Daniel, Daniel, oh, Daniel, Daniel, oh, the Hebrew Daniel, servant of the Lord.
Daniel, 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 Dani Thank you so much. On behalf of all our performers and our directors, I have a couple of quick thank yous. First of all, to our custodial staff and faculty and administration, Ms. Smith, to make an event like this happen just logistically takes a lot of collaboration. Yes, let's give them. I'd also like to give a really special thank you to Comcast. They do such an amazing job, and to be out here this evening to record this for us, we just really, really appreciate that very much. And my biggest thank you is to you, family, parents of all these talented students, hardworking students. We all know the sacrifice that's needed not only by the student in terms of time and effort, but by the entire family, the entire village, to make sure that this opportunity is available to them, and the extra rehearsals and early morning rehearsals and afternoon and evening rehearsals. And so thank you, parents, for allowing us in the Performing Arts Department to work with your great children. I hate to use the word children, but they're terrific, and we are very privileged to be able to work with them. Thank you very much. And then just a couple of reminders. Our Music Parents Association is hosting a reception immediately following, which is right in the commons area, so that will be right after the concert. We also wanted to point out to you that we are so, so fortunate to have RJ Recording, Richard Peck, the owner and master engineer with RJ Recording, is over there. Richard, give us a wave. When we decided to try this last year in this venue, a big, huge reason that we were able to do it is because of his expertise in not only recording our concert, but the live sound that you hear tonight. But just a reminder, again, what a great keepsake to order a CD from tonight's concert. And all our concerts will continue to be recorded this year, all the way throughout the year. So supporting that is fabulous for us to be able to keep doing that, and also, more importantly, fabulous for you to have a keepsake. So we want to remind you about that. And then the very last reminder I have, and we'll finish up, is all of our music students, tomorrow is uniform pickup day. We've told their students that from 2 o'clock to 7 o'clock tomorrow. But parents, you might not have heard about this yet, so if you haven't, we just want to tell you as well that it's really crucial for them to pick their uniforms up tomorrow, because of the rest of the year, that's what we'll be wearing for our concerts. Again, on the behalf of all of our music directors, thank you so much for allowing us to work with your kids. We're going to finish up one more tune from the marching band.
Hi, I'm John Quigley, President and CEO of the Elmhurst Chamber of Commerce and Industry. In these challenging economic times, it's imperative that our residents and businesses band together to not only shop Elmhurst, but buy Elmhurst whenever possible. We have great stores in our city center, Spring Road, Butterfield Road, York and Villette Streets, St. Charles and Route 83, North Avenue and Lake Street, along North York and even Grand Avenue. I ask for your help. Let's keep our tax dollars in Elmhurst.
Hi, I'm Elmhurst Police Chief Steve Newbauer. Elmhurst is a great place to live and work. However, we are not crime-free. Many people in our community become victims of crime simply because they did not lock their belongings. I would ask you to do two things. First, lock your car, house, and bike. Secondly, call 911 to report suspicious activity to the Elmhurst Police Department. The Elmhurst Police Department reminds you to lock it or lose it.
One in every 150 children is diagnosed with autism. Autism is treatable. Recovery is possible. To learn more about autism, contact the Autism Research Institute at autism.com. Don't let your child become a statistic.